Thank you. This, of course, is my fifth favorite class of the day, the sixth grade band. Wait, I only have four classes. I'm just kidding. These guys are awesome. I first want to congratulate them because we can actually hear the songs. It sounds bad, but I'm not even joking. At the beginning of the year, I don't think we could make it about 6 seconds before we were all over the place. These guys, because of the late start we got last year, have really only actually been playing their horns for about 10 months. And they're getting to a spot. The trumpets are hitting high notes. It doesn't seem like it's much right now, but for anybody who's a trumpet player, they're playing C's and D's back there. To do that in a year is pretty good. And it's really fun to watch their faces get bright red like mine does when they're trying to play those notes. Also, I want to welcome back to this group Owen and Connor, who have been with us all of 1 week. So we just started them on the drums. They had done other stuff, and they have come back and decided to do this. So their goal tonight is to play every beat. And I think they did a pretty good job on that. I'm glad to have them back. We're going to play two more for you. The first one is Ode to Joy. It's a quick one. And we want to have the distinguished ability to have played you your first holiday song of the season. Because technically, it's actually a Thanksgiving song. Even though everyone associates Jingle Bells on Christmas, it's actually a Thanksgiving song. We went back in the game. So we are going to play that when we finish our set, and then we'll get to the Jingle Bells.
Thank you.
This is, of course, our junior high band, grades 7 and 8. 7 and 8. That first song was called Air of Nobility, a nice little fanfare. This next one I know has been done in the past, but I wanted to feature our food section. I'm going to try and feature a different section of this band at each concert this year, since we have four of them. The next one at the December 14th concert is going to be the trumpets, and then we'll try and do the saxes and maybe the low bass and the clarinets. I want to make note before I forget. I began doing something this year. I started naming a student of mine. Anyone from grade 7 to 12 that I felt has really given something, an extra effort, has really impressed me, has done something throughout the course of the month. I have nothing to announce for November, but I want to quickly recognize the two people that were September and October. My September student of the month, based on some of the stuff he was doing in his practice time and different things, just a little bit of his playing, was Mr. Troy Fetter. A really cool thing that happened for me was I had a student who last year couldn't find notes, couldn't play, couldn't do anything. Didn't really work at it, and this year, started out kind of the same way, and, you know, it was kind of boring and that. And then he came for a lesson, and he had every part made. Absolutely every note, every rhythm, and could play just everything. And I just went, whoa. So October student of the month was J.D. Crown. This is Dancing with the Universe. Thank you. The trumpets are back in the three minutes. Because there was a little too many issues now. Ryan Bowers is a really, really great composer of young band music. He composed that one, he's composed the next one as well. It's a lot different. That one had some really funky notes in it, and most of them were supposed to be. There was a couple in there that most of that was supposed to be that way. Very slow and very dramatic, and the kids hate it because they don't like playing that stuff. Which is okay. But this next one is not. This is Fanfare on a Flute of Imagination. And I want you to pay really close attention to the percussion because they do really good work on this. It's fun watching the percussion run through their equipment because everything got pushed out of the way during basketball practice after school. And then reset up when we were here. We are going to close our set, and then there will be a slight transition time when the senior high comes down and the junior high goes to sit. Hopefully it'll take 2-3 minutes very quickly. This is one we're going to end with. Everyone, I'm pretty sure, knows if you're a fan of Disney. This is Under the Sea.
That's how it's supposed to be.
Here you go, Megan. There it is. Before we start, by looking at your programs at the first song that we're playing, raise your hand if you know what song this is. Good, I'm going to ask the same question after we play it.
Thank you.
Everybody more commonly knows it from 2001 A Space Odyssey. Our second one is a cute little overture by James Boyhart, called Sunderland Overture. Personally, of the songs we're doing, this is my favorite. The kids, I think, the last one probably never would be good. It's got a really nice little melody and some cool stuff going on in the middle section. And I gave these guys a new word this year. It's called schmaltz. I want you to schmaltz it up a little bit. I don't know why you need to do it. But it has to do with lots of wavy sounds and dynamics and stuff like that. It's just a term that I've heard band directors use forever. So I thought they needed to be introduced to it. This is Sunderland Overture.
Thank you.
It's been no secret that I've been pushing these guys very hard the last year and a half since I've been here. That song was a former member of the Class 3 Minnesota State Contest list. This next piece is on the state Class 2 contest list, and the following one is also on the Class 2, and it is a grade 4.5 song. The grading system, I talked about this a little last year, grade 4 is a standard to advanced high school. Grade 5 is a standard to advanced college. So grade 4.5 is somewhere in the middle there. I picked this concert this fall to push these guys really hard, and I think they paid it. If you'd asked me about 3 weeks ago whether or not we'd be ready for the night of, possible. It's a testament to these guys how much they work, because they have really come a long way, and I can almost guarantee you this is probably the longest, hardest concert these guys have ever played in their life. And that's for a reason, because of what we're going to try and do in the next couple of years. I've got a great group of kids here, and I want to thank them sincerely. This next song is a great arrangement of Amazing Grace by Frank Tichelli. He does a nice work with interweaving some of the different lines and stuff like that. There is a couple spots missing tonight. Unfortunately, Mrs. Remington emailed me today that her son was at home. He was one of the sick ones. There are a couple of horn one solo type parts that are going to be missing, so there'll be a couple spots where it's just kind of blocked, but there was supposed to be a French horn. But other than that, this piece is just absolutely gorgeous, and I can't wait to hear it. Thank you. Isn't that beautiful? I just love that song. One of the things that has to happen, that tends to happen when we get to this level of music, is lots of soloistic parts. Kids have really grasped their solos in this next one as well, all over the place. And if you didn't notice, the people I had standing in, of course, were the people that solo. This next one is called Prelude Siciliano and Rondo. It is by far the hardest piece we've played tonight. Which leads me, this is my story, into announcing what will be November's Student of the Month this year, or this month, because I am leaving tomorrow with Van and Carter Tour until December, so I'm going to announce it today. This person has really just taken a big leap and shown some great leadership this past month, despite having inferior equipment. And I couldn't be more proud of him. He actually came in and practiced in the band. I was just blown away. It earned him the title of Section Leader. November's Student of the Month is Jordan Phillips. I will state that this is three movements long, so please hold your thundering, roaring applause until the end of the third movement. I'll give you a hint, it's the fast, loud one.
Thank you.
better talk for about 4 minutes because I predicted we'd be done at 8:12. Was it 8:11? Then I got to talk for 3 minutes. I'm just kidding. We're going to talk for 3 minutes. I do want to thank you all for coming tonight. I know it is snowing out, and I wish you safe travels home. I also wish you a happy Thanksgiving holiday. I want to let you know that December 14th in the performance room will be the band, choir, holiday program, and it will not be as long as last year. That's why we have been in this soundtrack tonight. I was asked to make an announcement on your way out. I don't know where she's at. If you did not get your raffle ticket for the Booster Club, the Ice House, that is the $5 credit. You guys want to stay up? Okay, they'll be out outside the door. Go ahead and get your tickets. I know I bought two. I brought the whole one I never had before. Plus $40. Through your $5, you got a chance at a brand new ice cast. So thank you for coming. This last one, if you were at the girls' volleyball game, the last game, we played this as the run-out song. This is our closer. It's called Thunder. It is indeed the NASCAR theme. I'm a huge NASCAR fan. Jeff Gordon's going to win his fifth championship on Sunday. The day he retires. Kyle Busch. Oh, no. But if you ever listen to the credits, it's when they do their little, this is all rights reserved and all that stuff. This is the song that's playing in the background. This is Thunder, have a wonderful night.